Hello and welcome. My name is Kerry and this is my 2014 Ford F-150 truck. Recently I bought a Rhino Vortex rack system and in this video I'll go through the steps of assembling and installing the rack on my truck. The rack system comes in three boxes. What I'll do first is unpack the boxes and make sure I have all the parts needed to assemble the rack. Next I'll remove the end caps from the crossbars, then shake the crossbars to remove the measurement strips and the rubber buffer strips. Then I'll push the buffer strips into the crossbars and cut the strips to where they're even with the edge of each crossbar. Each leg on the crossbar takes a footplate with a rubber pad. Notice that each pad and each footplate has an arrow on it. What I need to do next is go to the specification sheet, locate my truck on the sheet, and find which direction the arrows need to point. In my application, the arrow on the pad needs to point to the inside of the truck, and the arrow on the footplate needs to point to the outside of the truck. With that knowledge, I'll install the pads on the footplates with the arrows pointing in. Then I'll install the footplates onto the legs with the arrows on the footplates pointing out. Each leg on the rack will have a specific location, and there are stickers provided to identify the position of the leg on the roof of the truck. With the stickers installed on the legs, the next step is to mount the legs onto the crossbars. To do that, I first need to go to the spec sheet again and find what length the measurement strips need to be. I found the spec sheet here to be a little confusing. There are multiple pages and the instructions don't say which measurements to use on the table. I found my truck in multiple locations and with different lengths for the strips. What I'll do is use the data for the 09 and later Ford Supercrew and hope the measurements work. For my application, the measurements for the strips on the front bar need to be 134 millimeters. Next, I'll take a pair of scissors and carefully cut two measurement strips that length. Next, I'll flip the crossbar onto its back and slide the measurement strip into the groove. Next, I'll take the left front leg, align the nut into the crossbar, and slide it to where it is flush with the measurement strip. Then I'll take the torque key and tighten the nut in the leg clockwise. When the nut is tight, I'll take what remains of the strip and slide it into the tube on the opposite side of the leg. Trim the strip flush with the end of the crossbar. Then reinsert the end cap into the crossbar and lock the cap with the blue key provided. With the left front leg installed, I'll move on to the right front leg. Install the strip into the groove. Slide the right front leg into the groove to where it is flush with the measurement strip. Tighten the nut in the leg. Slide the remaining strip on the opposite side of the leg and trim. Then insert the cap into the crossbar and lock it with the key provided. Okay, that completes the assembly on the front crossbar, so next I'll assemble the back crossbar. Assembly of the back crossbar is almost identical to the front crossbar, other than according to the instructions, the measurement strips that go into the bottom of the crossbars will be 130 millimeters instead of 134 millimeters. Before placing the bars on my truck, I'll go to the spec sheet again and find the spacing for the racks. In my application, I need to measure for the center of where the doors meet, 280 millimeters forward. This will be the center mark for the front crossbar. Then I'll measure 800 millimeters from the front mark to the rear of the truck, which will establish the center position of the leg on the rear crossbar. I've noticed that when the clamp is placed over the mark, it will cover it up. The clamp is 2 3/8 inches wide, so what I'll do is make another mark half that distance, which is 1 3/16 inches, forward of each center mark. This will give me a reference point to line up the front of each clamp. When the marks are made, I'll place arrow stickers to show each center mark for the clamps, so that if I remove then replace the rack system, I'll still have a reference point for the clamps. After placing the arrow stickers, I'll take the two assembled crossbars and set them on the truck. Next, I'll remove the bolt from the left front leg, insert it through the clamp, hook the curve in the lower part of the clamp into the door jamb, and begin tightening the bolt into the pivot nut. Then I'll go to the right side of the truck and repeat the same step. What I want to do is tighten the bolts evenly on the left and right legs to avoid pulling the rack too much to one side. When tight, the clamps should fit the curves in the door jamb, like shown here in the instructions. The clamps look good, so I'll move on to the back crossbar. The back crossbar is where I run into a snag. When I placed it on the roof, I noticed that the pads weren't spaced wide enough to allow the lips of the pads to seat into the groove in the truck roof like the pads on the front crossbar did. To me, it looks like the grooves in the truck are parallel, and the rear crossbar should have been assembled at the same width that the front crossbar was. So what I'll do is remove the legs off the crossbar, cut and add 4 millimeters of the measuring strip to each side of the crossbar. This will make each strip 134 millimeters, just like the front crossbar. The lip on the pads now look like they'll go into the grooves on the truck, so I'll remove the bolts from the legs and begin installing the clamps. Here again, I'll alternate tightening the bolts so that the crossbar doesn't pull too much to one side. When all the bolts are tight, I'll shake the crossbars up and down and front to back to make sure everything is nice and tight. Everything looks good, so next I'll take the covers and lock them into the legs. Notice that on the left side of each cover, there are lugs which go into the leg first. When each cover is in place, I'll take the key and turn it clockwise to lock the cover. So that completes this video on installing a Rhino rack system on a Ford truck. In my next video, I'll add a ski carrier to these racks, so I hope to see you then. If you like this video, please click the thumbs up, and to see more of my how-to videos, visit my channel iSkipper1 on YouTube.